you remember there was this key question, or two questions really, I said. You have to distinguish the question of what dies from the question of what really matters about death. What is it that makes death a tragedy when it is a tragedy? So we ask those questions. And here's the answer that I suggest is at least the best way of answering the question, what dies. It's drawing a distinction of the kind that I've mentioned before, and that you can see very clearly in the case of somebody like Tony Bland or Nancy Beth Cruzan, a distinction between the death of the human organism and the death of the person. So for deciding when the human organism dies, I think the obvious answer is the traditional one. It dies when the heart stops, the blood stops circulating, and essentially, you could say, decomposition sets in. Although, you know, decomposition may not set in immediately, you cannot tell it, but that's basically what's happening. And that's, therefore, the same kind of death for human beings as you have for non-human animals, or even for organisms that don't really have a distinct brain, like a plant or like some invertebrates, perhaps. So it's a general notion. We don't need to change that general notion of death that we're quite familiar with specifically for human beings if what we're talking about is the human organism. We're an organism in the same way that other animals are organisms, and we die in the same way. But, of course, we don't think that the death of every organism is really important, and that's something I'll come to, and that's in the what matters question we come to. And what we might think of as something different is the death of the person. So if you asked, as you remember that slide I showed last time of the gravestone of Nancy Beth Cruzan, which gave the three dates, her birth, when she lost consciousness, and when the organism died. And I would suggest that the best way to think about that is to say the person died at the time of the accident. Maybe we didn't know that the person had died at the time of the accident, because at the time of the accident we didn't immediately know that recovery was impossible, recovery of consciousness was impossible. But in fact, it was. So in fact, the person that Nancy Beth Cruzan's family and friends knew was irreversibly lost. The life of that person was ended, you could say, at the time of the accident. Whereas the organism died only when the feeding tube was withdrawn, the heart stopped, the blood stopped circulating, and so on. So that seems to me to be a useful way to ask, you know, what dies and when, at what stage does it die? And that, of course, leads to the ethical question. That's the next slide. This is a clarifying slide of what I said before. So if we talk about this in terms of the change of the definition of death, then we've moved to a definition of death in terms of whole brain death. So if what we're talking about is the death of the person, if that's what's of interest to us, well, it's true that when the whole brain is irreversibly ceased to function, the person is dead.